Sclerotinia is a fungal disease. It is a disease of cotton, but not commonly seen. It does have a very large host range of over 400 plants. Sclerotinia causes boll rots as well as stem rot in cotton. But there are very specific temperatures that this pathogen prefers, and so in cotton it's rather sporadic. And therefore we don't see it often, but when we do see it, it can be quite a significant problem. So when you walk into a field, you might notice some white cottony growth. This is the fungus growing on the stem. You might also see that spreading onto bowls. In a more severe case, you may actually see the whole stem and the plant infected. An outbreak can generally be worse if the canopy is very closed. It's highly vegetative, so that it's quite humid and moist and there isn't a lot of aeration. With regards to management, the fungus has a resting stage called a sclerote, and this structure can survive in the soil for a long time. When the sclerotes fall to the ground, under the right conditions, a mushroom-like structure will grow, and from this structure, ascospores are released, which then infect the cotton plant. Rain splash and wind greatly aid the distribution of the spores, which is why after extended periods of rainfall, this pathogen can be seen. Cultivation for management is not recommended because this buries the sclerotes and aids their survival. It is best to have, if you can, no-till or minimum till to leave the sclerotes on the surface where natural biocontrol can occur. With boll guard, where varieties require pupae busting, leaving the trash on the surface for as long as possible before cultivation will aid the breakdown of the sclerotes. Just because you do have an outbreak of sclerotinia does not mean that you're going to have a problem in the following season, because this pathogen requires quite specific environmental conditions. But if the problem was to occur again, rotating with a non-host will assist to reduce the inoculum.